In this video, let us explore more about the seed structure and the process of germination. After fertilization, the ripened ovule will become a seed. It contains the embryo which develop into a future new plant. And this embryo have structures called cotyledons. A cotyledon is nothing but the central part of the seed embryo, and to which two structures are attached, the plumule and the radicle. The plumule will develop into a future shoot system and the radicle will develop into a future root system. The seed is classified in two different ways. First, they are classified based on the number of cotyledons present in the embryo. Based on the number of cotyledons present in the embryo, it is divided into two types, dicotyledons and monocotyledons. If the embryo has only one cotyledon, then that is called by the name monocotyledons or monocot plant. Examples include maize and wheat. If the embryo has two cotyledons, then it is described as dicotyledon or dicot plant. Green peas, gram and kidney beans are the examples of dicot plants. The seeds are also classified in a different way based on the endosperms present. The endosperm is a tissue produced inside the seeds of most flowering plants after fertilization. It is usually triploid. It surrounds the embryo and provides nutrition in the form of starch. Sometimes it also contains oils and protein. On the basis of endosperm, the seeds are classified as albuminous and ex-albuminous. Albuminous seeds are the seeds which have food stored in special nourishing tissue called as endosperm. These endosperm remain persistent till the germination of the seeds. Ex-albuminous seeds are the seeds which have the stored food and the cotyledons in a special structure called kernel, and it does not remain until the embryo is fully mature. Let us discuss in detail about the structure of dicot seed first. A dicot seed is normally kidney shaped. It's flat and has a notch on one side. Dicots have two cotyledons inside the seed coat. They are usually rounded and fat because they contain the endosperm to feed the embryo of the plant. Dicot seed contains the following parts: hilum, micropyle, seed coat and the embryo. The hilum is the point where the seed is attached to the inner margin of the fruit. Micropyle is the opening through which the pollen tube enters the ovule. In the seed, the micropyle imbibes water and softens the seed coats and allows the embryo to emerge. It also allows diffusion of gases for respiration of the embryo. In dicots, the seed coat is further divided into two parts, the outer coat and the inner coat. The outer coat is called by the name testa and the inner coat is called by the name tegmen. The inner coat is usually thin, membranous and generally united with the testa. The seed coat is tough and waterproof. It also covers and protects the embryo and it is also responsible for the food supply. The embryo is the baby plant which emerges from the seed and germinates into a mature plant. The embryo consists of cotyledons. The cotyledons are also called by the name seed leaves or nurse leaves. They are fleshy, green, leaf-like structures and provide nourishment to the growing embryo. The cotyledon consists of radicle, which is the future root of the plant. It is the first to emerge out of the micropyle during germination process and it develops into a taproot in dicot plants. It also has plumule which develop into a future shoot. It has a growing point covered by and developed delicate tiny leaves and it is attached to the radicle by the structure called hypocotyle.